Is that the best you can do? Hell yeah.
Disappearing act.
Get lost.
Want some more?
Pleasure was all mine. You're not leaving here in one piece. Yours. Whatever. My pleasure.
Hey, buddy, you here to help? My friend Jack's in trouble.
I just got here, but yeah.
Okay, good. I can get us in, but first, I need a key. The kind that'll work on any door? The kind that looks like a bobby pin?
Here you go.
Great! Now, before I open this door, I gotta ask, who are you? And can I trust you to help me?
You first. What's your name?
Don't have a name. I'm sort of borrowing a friend's. You can call him Jack. I guess by that logic, I'm not Jack. Or maybe I am? I don't know anymore. The point is, I could be either. I just need to know if you're gonna help me save him.
I'll do what I can.
Perfect. Just follow my lead. Figuratively. I'll be following you inside, literally. So try and look as confused as I made that sound. You'll figure it out once we get inside. All you need to know is, Jack is in trouble, and the clock is ticking. Tick, tick, tick.
Here, Arthur D.
Present.
Good. Now that everyone's present and accounted for, here's the deal. This man here is a synth. He's also my prisoner. Now, if you're all wondering why I've locked you inside, well, it's not to keep you in. It's to keep the Institute out. That's right. They got men all over the Commonwealth looking for this sumbitch. So I'd appreciate it if you just showed a little patience while we rest up. Come morning, we'll be over your skin and out of your hair.
Nonsense dangerous? Why not just shoot him?
Sure, I could do that. Just cut the damn red wire and let him die. But then who's gonna explain to the scientists over at the facility why their fancy synthetic android is nothing more than a lifeless doll? See, I need him intact, so that they can poke and prod and do whatever it is sciencey types do to their guinea pigs.
Except you've got the wrong guy, Jack. Or should I say, the wrong Jack guy.
And here's your proof right
there. There's two of them.
That's right. Two Jacks, one synth.
Yeah, but he's not the synth. I am.
Well, you're certainly as ugly as he is. But short of shooting you dead, I don't suppose you have any proof.
Not really. You can open us up, but chances are you'd find the same bones.
He's right. I heard the Institute makes exact replicas. Right down to the teeth.
You kidding me?
Jesus.
You shouldn't have come, Jack. Now they know. You know how it is, Jack. I just couldn't leave you to die either. That'd be a little too heavy, even for me.
Well, stick me in a jar and call me Dill. This is what I call a real fucking pickle.
Oh, God. Now what are we gonna do?
It's simple. We lock this place down until we figure out who's got the nuts and who's got the bolts. And I have a feeling this scabber over here can help us. You. Come over here.
Jack,
you know this man
who dies.
He doesn't deserve
any
of this. He's been acting different, but is he a synth? That just sounds so far-fetched. Sorry, I barely know the guy.
Well, you came in with him, didn't you? Or do you go around just helping any old dumb fuck who asks you for help? How about this? Why don't you interrogate them for me? I'll be standing here watching you do it. Now, I've got my own opinion. But let's see if we can't come to a consensus.
What is this place, anyway?
Nothing special, that's for sure. Just another Commonwealth shit stop run by Art and his auntie. Normally, I don't like stopping anywhere with more than one entry point, but Art assured me that lock couldn't be picked. I would kill him just on principle, but he ain't worth the ammo.
I don't have any more questions.
Good. Then you can stop bothering me and start questioning them. You find out which one is the synth, then I take him to my handlers. Easy peasy, Japanesey. But there's one condition. Don't hurt him. Not a scratch, you hear? The contract I have specifically states they're to be delivered undamaged.
To be perfectly honest, I don't think the Institute really exists. It's just wild rumors and nonsense.
Hi.
It doesn't matter which one you ask. Jack and I will give you the same answer. But if you choose wrong, this bounty hunter will come back and finish what he started. Which means the best solution is to kill the hunter and let us go free.
Look, I'm sure we can work this out. No one has to die.
You sound like Jack. Always trying to find another way. He's a fool, of course. The shortest distance between two points is a straight line.
Sure, he's been acting a little strange lately, but a synth? That just seems so outlandish.
I think there's a way out of this, without anyone getting hurt.
I see you've calculated all the variables, just like a machine.
Well, yeah, I'm a synth, it's what I do. Anyways, here's my plan. The bounty hunter said we're no good to him damaged, right? So what if we damaged ourselves? You shoot Jack, I shoot non-Jack, and no one has to die. Peace through violence. Just not too much violence. Or else.
Hi there.
Hi, how are you? Trust the synth. I don't know what to think anymore.
Hey there.
So, did I have the right guy all along?
I'd go with the other one.
Yeah, it'd go against my gut instinct. But it's hard to listen to your stomach when it talks out of its ass. Alright, I'll take this one. You're free to go.
Smart choice. To be honest, I never trusted Jack to begin with.
Yeah, you would say that. But if you're lying to me, you best believe I'm coming back for you. Now come on, Jack. Time to get back in the box like a good little toaster. We're sending your ass factory sealed.
Jack and I had an arrangement. We'd split the work and have twice the free time.